हाय विनोद,
हेलो, गुड मॉर्निंग कोच.
हाय। हाँ
देयर यू आर. ओके, आई लाइक योर ब्राइट ग्रीन वॉल बिहाइंड.
यस, यू लाइक इट? हाँ, दिस इज माय योगा रूम।
ओके, गुड
हाय
मॉर्निंग
विनोदा।
फाइनेंस. गुड मॉर्निंग, हाउ आर यू?
मॉर्निंग, फाइन।
लवली टू सी बोथ ऑफ यू ऑलवेज.
मॉर्निंग इंद्रेश भाई। हाँ कन्नन भाई, हाउ आर यू? ऑल वेल, गुड टू सी यू
अंदर
मैम।
अंदर A6 ने पाता थी मैं करी अनेक रेंड पेर ना अर्पण करने
ओह
नेट
गुड
इतना
गुड।
सुलिंग डर है.
हाँ ओके, ग्रेट ग्रेट, गुड टू सी यू। एवरी
ओके, डॉक्टर विद्या इज हियर.
हेलो सर, कैन यू हियर मी?
हाय डॉग।
मॉर्निंग
हेलो,
डॉक्टर
हाय,
विद्या,
गुड
वेलकम.
मॉर्निंग, गुड
गुड मॉर्निंग विनोदा, गुड मॉर्निंग कनन सर, सदा मैम, गुड मॉर्निंग.
मॉर्निंग, गुड मॉर्निंग, गुड मॉर्निंग।
स्टार्ट विनोदा।
ओके, गुड मॉर्निंग वन एंड ऑल. वी ऑल नो A6 रनिंग क्लब हैज बीन इन चेन्नई फॉर ओवर 3 इयर्स, एंड द ग्रुप इज लेड बाय आवर कोच इद्रिस. वी बीन प्रोवाइडिंग ट्रेनिंग सेशंस, बट ड्यू टू द पैंडेमिक वी बीन फॉलोइंग इंडोर वर्कआउट्स अंडर हिज गाइडेंस. And it's our pleasure to welcome Dr. Vidya here today, where she'll throw us some insights about mental health, how crucial it is at this pandemic time, and also for general well-being. And let me share a few words about Dr. Vidya. It's a big paragraph. I couldn't memorize, so I'm going to read it out. So Dr. Vidya Hari Iyer is a passionate psychotherapist and a counselor practicing for over a decade. She holds an MS in psychotherapy and counseling, and an MPhil in counseling. She's also a qualified laser dentist. This multi-talented entrepreneur is also a behavioral analyst, a life and leadership coach. For over 12 years, Dr. Vidya Hari has worked for several social causes ranging from women empowerment, cancer awareness in women, inspiring young kids, community mental health for all, and many more. She's nothing less than an inspiration to the youth. And we like her motto of smiles with miles today as a runner.
So thank you so much, Vinoda, for this kind words, and thank you, Idris sir, for this opportunity.
Yes,
It's indeed a
I mean,
pleasure.
doc, 2 weeks back, I mean, few weeks back, you have interviewed me. So this is our turn to interview you. So it's so happy. Congratulations to start with. You had that golden jubilee last week. It was fantastic. And the message you were spreading, interviewing a lot of experts for the awareness of health and fitness. Hats off to your work. And please proceed now.
Thank you so much, Idris sir. It really means a lot because I guess, every one of us were just trying to find out what best we can give to the community. I think that it was as simple as that. And sir was referring to the Get In, Get Fit series, which I conduct. And it all started last March. Actually, we all went into lockdown. We didn't understand much about what the lockdown was because we never experienced it. None of us, for that matter, right? So sudden lockdown was like, sudden cut. It was like, a cut from society. So that is how all of us jumped from offline to online. And even if we did not know Zoom or Google, we were all, just getting engaged into that. And being a psychotherapist, I started getting a number of calls. Almost in a day, I used to get about 5 to 6 calls, and each of those calls used to run for about 45 minutes to an hour. And obviously, people were trying to, take a analysis about their life and how it was going, and nothing was very positive about what they were saying. And they were losing jobs, they were having a cut in their salary, and a lot more things like that. People were losing their loved ones, and many of their family members were hospitalized, and money, economical crunch began. So it was a lot of things happening at the same time. So, you know, listening to all this day in and day out. And then I decided, I'm not a very social media person. So that is me. That is from where I come. I have had a very busy life pre-COVID. I was not into social media, nothing to do with Facebook, WhatsApp, status, nothing to do with Insta. I was in my own world, very happy. But then when all this started coming up, I said I needed to do my bit. It was just not, you know, giving or servicing these five or six people on a daily basis, because I thought the need was more. Few people don't talk about it. Few people are shy. Few people feel others might judge them just because of they might brand them or things like that. And all this became a very, very important aspect of life. And so I said, okay, let me put a positive post every day on social media. So I welcomed the social media, and every day as I kept putting, I started getting very good responses. Now, when I mean very good responses, see, I have been in the teaching industry for almost 26 plus years. I've been a teacher in dentistry and of course in psychotherapy too. My students are far and wide. So they started saying, oh ma'am, it's so nice to wake up to your messages and things like that. That's when I said I needed to take this to a little more, one notch up. And that is how the Get In Get Fit series started. And I wanted it to be a very holistic one. Many people were talking about weight loss, body transformations. For me, it was just not about the physical being. Because I look at a person, I don't look at how they look first. For me, it is their internal being. It is much more than what we can see with our eyes. And I personally feel connected with the soul. So, you know, that is how I felt I needed to reach out much more. So I have a small presentation right away, and I would start sharing my screen to help you understand what exactly all this is about. So can I have the screen sharing, please? That is exactly how things started working up. And pretty much what happened was, everybody started asking about how they can go ahead with their life. And then I felt, there was much more to what we can think and do. So just give me a second as I open up my presentation. Okay, before I done. This is how, the whole journey of Get In Get Fit started. And today, of course, we have celebrated our Golden Jubilee celebrations. And it is such an immense pleasure to understand that, so many positive things have happened in life. So I would like to first thank Idris sir and Vinoda for this wonderful opportunity, and ASICS Running Club Chennai for being present this topic, Your Mental Health Matters. So, so your mental health is a priority. I guess we need to mute before we go ahead, otherwise you will not have a good recording. I request all the people on this program to kindly mute yourselves. Thank you so much. Okay, so your mental health is a priority. Many people take this for granted. But even WHO had, spoken about mental health. They said health is just not the physical fitness or, it is also with the mental toughness. So this is so very important as we think about it, because health is all about well-being. It's about your thoughts, your feelings, your emotions, and your behavior totally put in together, that it makes you the person you are. So whenever you meet a person, generally when you ask a person, hi, how are you? The answer you would get is, yeah, I'm fine. I'm doing good. And then when you keep asking them, or then when you keep talking to them for some more time, that's when they would start, you know, once they feel that comfort level, they'll break the ice and then they will open out what they really feel inside. So generally, when we talk to people, we say, do you want to talk about it? Or we always just say, I'm always there for you. What can I do to help you? That sounds really difficult. I'm really sorry you're going through this. Or are you looking for my perspective, or you just want me to listen to you? So these are the pretty much things which, you know, we try to ask our friends. Now, mental health includes emotional, psychological. Mr. Mithukumaran, I would request you to kindly keep yourself on mute. We're having a recording done, and this is disturbing us. Thank you so much. So mental health includes your emotional, psychological, and social well-being. It affects how we think, feel, and act. It also helps determine how we can handle stress, in either it is related to us or to others, or to make healthy choices. See, every time in life, we will be given two choices, and it is up to us to decide which way we want to go. Mental health is important at every stage of life. It could be from childhood to adolescent to adulthood. So what are the causes of these mental health problems? If you look at it, these are the broadly classified ones. You have childhood abuse. Many people don't know the art of parenting. And sometimes people learn from their mistakes and try to correct it with their grandchildren. So that's how it works. Trauma, neglect, social isolation or loneliness, discrimination or stigma, and sexual violence. I'm sure with the pandemic, you would have understood that we have social isolation or loneliness and discrimination of people having the COVID versus not having COVID. All that was there in the beginning stage. And now it is most of the post-traumatic stress or depression or panic attacks or even phobia of seeing one another or any other person also. What are the warning signs of mental illness? It could be from varied emotions which you would display, and your face is the best emotion. So when you're feeling anxious or worried, when you're feeling depressed or unhappy, there are some emotional outbursts. You would not react or respond to a particular situation that way in an ordinary day. But now you are, you know, just throwing out your anger or your frustration on people. And generally in a household, the man throws it at the wife throws it at the children, if there is a puppy or a toy, they would hit or bang the toy. So that's the way it goes. And then you would have insomnia or sleep problems. You would have weight or appetite changes. You will start putting on weight, or you will start eating. Either you would overeat, that we call as the binge eating, or you would go into not eating at all or depriving your body of food. Next is being very quiet or withdrawn. Now, this is again, you know, you have a paradigm shift. Either people become very talkative and hide their feelings, or they go into this kind of a quiet or a withdrawn feel. And some of them get into some kind of substance abuse. It could be tobacco, it could be smoking, it could be alcohol, it could be drug, or it could be some medication which they get, you know, attached to so much that without that, they have extreme withdrawals. And some get into this feeling of being guilty or feeling of worthlessness. And they start, you know, just thinking about things that they are good for nothing. And this is where you would see many of them getting into a kind of, you know, suicidal attempts. And you would also see some changes in behavior or feelings. And this is very important because, you know, when you are able to know a particular person and suddenly you see changes, that is where you would have a hell of a lot of difference. So as Stephen in Mental Health Matters said, our mental health is our priority. Therefore, let's put in more effort in love, in care, in talking to others, in treating ourselves like kings and queens that we are. Self-pity, don't do that stuff, because deep down we got gold, we got warmth, and we got sunshine ready to shine through our lives and the lives of others. Mental health matters. So this is very important. We need to understand that each one of us are unique. Each one of us have that power in us, which is not confined with just our physical being or ourselves. And we can radiate that kind of positivity outside. So I'm going to give you just 7 tips today, just 7 of them. And if you find these important or very nice, then you know you can apply them in your daily life. The first one is a mental break. So if you see, 1 out of 4 people are affected by mental illness. 8.6 million adults have got suicidal thoughts. Suicide is the 3rd leading cause of death. Children and anxiety disorders are less likely to receive treatment. And 1 in 30 experience the post-traumatic stress disorder. And people of various colors, like we are all dark colored. There are people who are fair skinned. So there is a study which says that people who are dark skinned have less access to care. So how can you do that? You can have a movement break. What does that mean? You can start walking, running, do anything you want, which keeps you moving. Next is a mental break. Now, how do you have a mental break? If something is upsetting you, then don't think about it. Just let it be and then go ahead with what makes you feel happy. Have a social break. See, many a times we see people posting something and other people, you know, stalking them or, you know, trying to say whatever they want. See, speaking or commenting on others is anybody's choice, right? But when you comment, you should also put in your yourself in that shoe and speak something nice. If you don't want to speak anything, don't speak. That's the best way. But if you speak, speak positive. That can be a very nice way of conveying yourself. Many of us take nature breaks. I'm sure all of us do this. In a year, we all try to go for a holiday, and mostly we prefer any hill stations or some kind of a you know, calm place with our family. We don't want a routine. We just want to enjoy nature, enjoy the green and the blue in life, and then come back home. And then you can have a creative break. I'm sure many of you must have noticed, even in social media, people putting up their drawings, their paintings. So creative break is another very important thing. Second is to let go. Now, this is a very beautiful, I would say a weapon, but we call it, you know, a prayer. So this is called the serenity prayer. And it says, you know, God, give me the serenity to accept the things I cannot change. So acceptance is something very important. There are so many things happening in life. And if we can't accept it, there itself we break the chain from mental illness. Okay, so when you accept things, it is very nice. You accept things, and then next thing is courage to change the things you can. So you need to develop that courage, that whatever is in your control that you can change, you need to change it. And wisdom to know the difference. So this is again very important, and you'll find that it is necessary to let things go. Now, what all do you think you need to let go? Sometimes you need to let go of situations. People were nasty with you, let go. People in terms of people themselves spoke something bad about you, let go of that people, let go of that bond. Only because you're holding on to those emotions that is running in your mind and coming back as memories. Next, you let go of the circumstances which led you to that scene or whatever it could be in your life. And simply for that reason that they are heavy, so let go. Just let go of them. We gently say, take a glass of water and keep you know, holding it for a longer period of time. After about 10 minutes, even that glass of water will make you feel heavy. So just let go of the glass, you'll feel very light. Our mind is just the same. Why do you want to, you know, hold on to the negative memories? Instead, put a lot of positive memories into that and make it flourish. Make it like a garden that you would want to see bloom every day. When you let go, you create space for something better. I just saw a beautiful short video about a woman And this woman was trying for a child and she couldn't conceive. So she went in for the IVFs and that also she did not conceive. And she was really heartbroken. So she goes in for an adoption center and she's waiting to see her child. And here a child just walks into the room. And as she turns back and sees the child and that love in the eyes of the child, she just hugs the child and she said, you know, I didn't get all that done because you were waiting for me and I didn't know about that. And that was so magical a moment. So sometimes you just need to let go of certain things. Maybe it's just not meant for you. Like we have heard the story of the fox and the grapes. The fox just let go of the grapes, saying that it's sour. I don't need it. It's as simple as that. We were taught to let go very early in childhood, but we didn't understand the moral of the stories then. Make peace with yourself. We can never obtain peace in the outer world unless we make peace with ourselves. So this is very, very, very important. So focus your attention on those things that you can control. See, that is exactly what the Serenity Prayer says. So whatever is in your control. So take a piece of paper and write in two areas. Write one side what all are in your control. Waking up on time is in your control. Doing some kind of a physical exercise is in your control. Eating right is in your control. Speaking right is in your control. Thinking right is in your control. All this is in your control. So you should be able to work out on that. Now, when you don't work out on that, that is when the problem arises. So, you know, it is very important for all of us to do things which is in our control. Now, then there are things which is not in your control. Leave it to the Almighty. I mean, you know, He is so benevolent. He's so forgiving. He is full of miracles and He's going to bless you abundantly. It is just that your time has to come. You know, they say, aap katar mein hai, which means you are in line, right? So that's exactly how it is. So just wait and understand what are in your control and what are not in your control and let go of the things which is not in your control because something better is waiting for you. Spend time with nature. Be true to yourself. Now, many a times when I generally, you know, give some suggestions, people say, so do you want me to fake it? Or do you want me to say that I'm happy outside when I'm, you know, so worried inside? That's not true. We want you to acknowledge whatever your mind or your heart is saying. And that is so very important. And this is something which, you know, we need to really look take into account. Next is doing good deeds as much as possible. Try to do good things for the others. See, whenever we pray, we say knowingly or unknowingly, if we have done anything wrong to people, if we have said anything wrong to people, God forgive me. So, you know, this is so important. I'm sure if, you know, you practice Buddhism or you practice Jainism, they do this, right? So this is so very important because unknowingly also, we should not hurt others. Unknowingly also, we should not do anything wrong towards others. So, and it is not possible. We are all human beings. We might do something which might not be the right way of working. So it's always, you know, better to have a conscious decision to do something good. Be assertive. Now, being stubborn and being assertive are two different things. Being stubborn is in the negative language. Being assertive is in the positive language. Speak what you want, ask what you want, and you know, express what you want. That is very important, especially with your loved ones. Now, with your own people, you don't have to put up an act or something. And if you can radiate that towards your friends, then you will have true friends for life. So being assertive is in a very nice way. And of course, being meditative and resist the spirit of procrastination. Whatever you can do it, do it now. have that kind of an attitude of doing it right away and keep away from any distractions. Now, this is something which I learned over time. And, you know, I have my day compartmentalized and I have exactly a time for every aspect or element of my life. And I live my life the way I want. So similarly, each of you have that option and you can eliminate any kind of distractions and set boundaries for interruption. There are many a times people just speak what they want and then they are off from your radar, right? And but then all what they said keeps running in your minds. So how much of their words or their thoughts are you going to take it into yours? You need to set those boundaries so that you can have peace with yourself. Next is modifying your life. Now, that is another very important thing. Most of us have lifestyle issues. We sleep late, we get up late, we are not on time for anything. We are always rushing against time. And when you look at successful people, you will find that, you know, they wake up at least 1 hour early. They have some me time and then they prioritize their things in life. And that is how they are being able to achieve better. So modifying your life and having better lifestyle changes really plays a very important role. Next is to pray and to listen. So this is another very important thing. The only person who's absolutely non-judgmental in this entire universe is God. Now, when you pray to him, there is a beautiful kind of a connect which you have. And I generally pray early morning at 4 o'clock. I have an alarm set. Generally, we get up 5 or 10 minutes before the alarm. And as you would see the road. Now, during lockdown, I'm sure most of you must have felt that the roads were empty. There was less traffic, less pollution. That's exactly the time in the morning. When there is less traffic, not many people are connecting to God at that time. How about connecting to God at that time, right? In Hinduism, we say Brahma Muhurtam, wherein you mean the Muhurtam or the time, which is very nice to think about God. So this is very, very important. When you connect with God, when you speak with God, when you think about God as your friend, it is so easy that, you know, he will guide you, he will protect you, and he'll take you forward. Next is to think positive. Stay positive and better days are always in front of you. Never, you know, bask so much in the past. Past was just to give you some kind of an experience in life. The present, it is for you to experience life to the fullest. And the future is to be very hopeful, have faith and have belief in the unseen. So learn to be positive always in pleasure and in pain. In sun or in rain, in loss or in gain, always be positive. That is so very important in life. Next is to be active. Now, as I told you, you need to be, you know, very active in terms of physical exercise. Just be agile. Just do something much more than what you used to do before. Do some kind of an activity. Keep yourself always bubbling with energy. And be busy, but be productive and active. Many a times I have heard people say, you know, I'm active. But the next question I ask them is, are you productive? Now, that is also very important. Being active means doing something, like busy like a bee. Or if you look at a dog on the road, any car comes and goes, the dog will run behind the car. So are we that way? Are we just running around? Or we are getting results from what we are doing? So are we being productive? That's very important. And for that, you need to have your parameters in place. And you could just, you know, check on yourself how well you're doing from what you were yesterday to what you can be tomorrow. Next is to show compassion. The purpose of human life is to serve and to show compassion and the will to help others, as Albert said. This is very important. And how do you show compassion? Many a times, it is not about showing compassion only to others. It is also to yourself. Many a times I have, you know, felt people are very strict or very critical with themselves. That's not the way you analyze yourself. You should give a pat on your back for the little things you do in a day. if you have set a target of doing so many work in the day, even if it's household work, and you were able to complete it by night, give a tap on your back and say, you did it. So be empathetic, be encouraging, show emotions, show kindness. Listen without interrupting, especially this is between spouses. When some spouse or one a person is talking, lend them your ears. And you know, they all that they want is just that. And be an advocate. Understand the good and the bad and go towards the best. Volunteer, show respect and show consideration. Next is practicing gratefulness. I mean, I have a small jar on my dining table and that I called as the blessing jar. And every day in the morning, I take a small chit of paper and I write, what am I grateful for? You can be grateful for anything in life. You woke up in the morning today. Many people did not wake up. So you can be grateful that for that. You have good, healthy life. You have food to eat on the table. You have good clothes to wear. You have a good knowledge about whatever you're doing. You know, you can be grateful for your family, your friends, for the time God has given you to do good. So being grateful and practicing gratefulness are the keys to a happier life. And gratefulness or gratitude can change everything. Just imagine you go up to your wife and say that, you know, she made a nice cup of coffee. The next time she makes coffee, she'll remember and pour in some more love so that, you know, you can have a better coffee. Go to your wife and say that, you know, you've kept your house very neat. Next time she will put that extra effort to see that the house is well. Tell your husband, I'm so grateful for you that you go out even during this pandemic and work hard so that we can all have a better life. Show gratitude to people. It means the world to people. So it's up to you today to start making healthy choices. Not all choices are just healthy for your body, but healthy for your soul and mind too. So I'm going to take you through a very short 3-minute meditation. And I just want you all to relax and listen to this music. Close your eyes and just follow my instructions. Keep your body still. Let your body loose. Keep your feet on the ground. If you're sitting, keep your back erect. And if you're lying down, just relax your muscles. Take a deep breath in. Enjoy this music, the tranquility which your mind needs, the peace you're searching for outside, honestly lies within you. You are going to make the difference. You're going to take charge of your life. Whatever is in your capacity, you should get that done. Relax your feet, your toes, your legs, your thighs, your abdomen, your internal organs. Back, your hands, your palm, your fingers, your neck, your head, your brain, your eyes, nose, ears, and all your sensory organs. Command them to relax. Be grateful for the life you have today. can you be good? How can you do good? And what good you're planning to do for others and for yourself? Let's be the change. Let's change from within. This too shall pass. Together we'll make a difference. So your take-home message is: witness your feelings, affirm them, draw your feelings in order to understand yourself better. Don't minimize your pain or focus just by cheering yourself up or cheering others. But give yourself the physical affection you need, affirm support and commitment, and this too shall pass. Thank you so much. This is my number, 98401-76088. I'm open to questions at this point of time.
Thank you, Doctor. That was a beautiful insight and a very optimistic approach towards life, right from the start of the day to the end.
Thank you so much, Vinoda. If there are any questions I would like to share, what I personally feel is it's all up to us to make a difference. I guess everybody has something going on in their lives. No one is free. I always say there are only two places where a man can be free. It is said better in Tamil, either it is in karu arai or kallarai, which means it's either in the mother's womb or it is in the, you know, in the coffin. So ultimately what we need to do is all of us have our life, our challenges, but to overcome the challenge is the very essence of life. Whenever you see a movie, you go for a 3-hour entertainment, but it is not all sweet, right? You have a sorrow, you have a lows, highs, and that is how it is. So pretty much if you look at life, don't you want to make your life interesting? And each of our lives are going to be interesting only when we have all elements in life. Yeah. So take care and all the best. And
thank you, Doc. Thank you so much. Yeah.
Thank you, Doctor. We truly appreciate your time.
Thank you so much. Thank you.